It's been over four decades since the Boeing 757 took to the skies for the first time. Developed as a successor to the Boeing 727, it may not have been the best-selling single-aisle model in Boeing's history, but it's a type that many pilots and aviation enthusiasts respect and revere. While it's no longer in production, the 757 continues to serve in commercial and cargo operations today. But what exactly gives the 757 its iconic status? What is it about the jet that people love? Let's explore this topic for today's video. Boeing concluded production of the 757 about two decades ago in 2004. When all was said and done, there were a total of 1,050 airframes manufactured during its production run. Most of these were 757-200s, while a smaller number were the extended 757-300 models. Even as newer Boeing 757s approach 25 years of age, over 500 of these airframes are still actively flying with 47 different airlines, at least according to data from CH Aviation from late July 2024. And so, the first factor making the 757 an iconic jet is the power relative to its size. Many pilots call the 757 a sports car in the sky. The aircraft is said to fly best when it is light, and its handling is described as, quote, almost perfectly neutral. Indeed, some have gone so far as to say that handling of the Boeing 757 is the way one should expect an airliner to fly. For example, the large rudder on the airliner makes quick work of crosswinds and V1 cuts. The 757 is sometimes regarded as one of the best designs the Boeing engineers got right, at least from a pilot's perspective. Commentators point out that no modern design performs its mission as well as the 757. The Boeing 757 was engineered with powerful engines considering the size of its airframe. The 757 came with two engine choices, the Rolls-Royce RB211 high bypass turbofan and the Pratt & Whitney PW2037. Rolls-Royce engines provided 37,400 pounds or 166 kilonewtons of thrust per engine at full throttle, an uncommon level of power for the slender 757 design. Pratt & Whitney PW2037 engines provided 38,200 pounds or 170 kilonewtons of thrust each. Both engine options enable the 757 to achieve takeoff on runways as short as 6,000 to 7,000 feet or 1,660 to 2,070 meters in length under 140 knots. This has given the type's operators the ability to fly from smaller and more remote airports. Interestingly, it was the first time that Boeing launched an aircraft with a non-domestic engine manufacturer. Another aspect that made the Boeing 757 genuinely unique and versatile for its time was its cockpit design. These days, pilots may find the flight deck quaintly antiquated. However, when it first flew in 1982, it was a rather revolutionary aircraft. In the 1970s, Boeing ruled the commercial aviation scene because Airbus was just starting out. As it stood, Boeing's planes like the 707 and 727 trijet dominated the commercial skies. When Boeing introduced the 757, it brought something new, a glass cockpit, which earlier single-aisle aircraft like the 727 did not have. The introduction of this high-tech cockpit made it feasible to fly further with only just two crew members in the cockpit, with the engineer no longer needed on board. Other aircraft had also transitioned to two crew cockpits, but the 757 took safety a step further with the EFIS, or Electronic Flight Instrument System, glass cockpit. It's worth noting that the Boeing 757 was developed concurrently with the Boeing 767 widebody. Therefore, the cockpit is virtually identical, making it easy for pilots to transition between the two aircraft. The next notable 757 feature is its supercritical wings. The Boeing 757 was an early aircraft incorporating what's called a supercritical wing design. This wing design underwent testing in the 1970s, around the same time the 757 was being designed. Unlike conventional wings that are rounded on top and flat on the bottom, supercritical wings have a flatter top and a rounded bottom. These supercritical wings effectively reduce aerodynamic drag, resulting in enhanced fuel efficiency, improved cooling, better engine compartment layout, and reduced production costs. According to NASA, testing validated wind tunnel data, showing the supercritical wing increased efficiency by as much as 15%. This made the 757 a worthy competitor in the market at the time. In addition to the 757, Boeing decided to include the supercritical wing design on their Boeing 767s, Boeing 777s, and their C-17 military transport aircraft. Our next point is more of a coincidence based on airline preferences rather than something built into the structural design of the 757. Nonetheless, based on multiple historical flight reviews and other information gathered, there's some indication that passengers feel comfortable traveling on the aircraft. Although subjective and highly variable between airline operators, some passengers consider this jet as being more comfortable than the popular Boeing 737 or Airbus A320 series of aircraft. Indeed, before considering airline configuration, we know that the 757 had comparable cabin dimensions as the 737NG. The 757 has a cabin height of about 214 centimeters or 84.2 inches. This is slightly less than the 737NG's 220 centimeters or 86.6 inches. Cabin width is close, with the 737NG being about an inch wider. Both also sport a 3-3 seating configuration for economy class. And so, with all of this in mind, any feelings of elevated comfort and spaciousness on the 757 seem to come from the interior fitting of the airline. Nonetheless, according to Boeing, the 757 can accommodate between 200 and 295 passengers, depending on the configuration and variant. And nearing the end of our video, it's worth mentioning that the Boeing 757 was one of the first aircraft designed specifically for the short and medium haul market. According to its specifications, the 757-200 variant can fly as far as 3,900 nautical miles or 7,220 kilometers, and the larger 757-300 variant can reach a maximum range of 3,395 nautical miles or 6,287 kilometers. In comparison, the Boeing 727 was more suited to operating shorter trips, as the 727-100 variant had a maximum range of 2,300 nautical miles or 4,300 kilometers. The 757 was one of the first aircraft to be granted extended twin-engine operational performance standards, or ETOPS, certification. Not only is it ideal for domestic flights within the US, the jet is capable of completing popular transatlantic city pairings non-stop, making it a rather versatile aircraft for operators. Quite sadly, for AV geeks and even some airline operators, it seems there was never really a proper replacement for the Boeing 757. This is partly why airlines have continued to fly it. Many airlines and pilots hope that Boeing's new midsize airplane, culturally called the Boeing 797, will fill the gap left by the now aging 757 fleet. Of course, it's far from certain that the Boeing 797 will ever go into production. Now feeling more like a myth, the Boeing 797 project started in 2015, around 11 years after the Boeing 757 went out of production. Various airlines had expressed interest in the new aircraft in those early years. However, the pandemic was a major factor scuttling any new aircraft progress. Boeing's more recent troubles over manufacturing and assembly quality have only further delayed progress on developing a new type. So, what do you think of the Boeing 757? How long do you think the type will continue to be operated by airlines? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.